Today we will look at the slick guitar, the SL-59. Look at this. Isn't that a beautiful guitar? And I will explain in a minute why I think this is a really beautiful guitar. Let's talk about Slick at first. For the people that don't know it, Earl Slick, I knew him before. Earl Slick is known for his works with David Bowie and John Lennon. And yeah, he's a guitarist, and the guy should know what a good guitar should sound like and look like and stuff. And yeah, we got here now the Earl Slick guitars. These guitars are not so very well known here in Europe so far. They are well known, if I'm not wrong, in the USA so far. Guitarfetish.com, that's where they come from. And they are available since, I'm not sure, 1 year, 2 years now here in Germany and in Europe. If I'm not wrong, I don't know. But we will look now here at the SL-59. Thanks to Music Vine here in Germany for lending me this guitar and the yellow one and the other guitars. And yeah, let's go through the specifications. And let me start with the things on this guitar that really blew me away, okay? I didn't expect this. We got here really a brass bridge, okay? We got here massive brass saddles for every string. We can fix them here with the screws. We can intonate the guitar perfectly and fix the saddles with the screws. The bridge itself can be fixed too with two screws. So we got here really a massive bridge with brass saddles. Also, we got here brass tuning pegs, and we got here really a lot of sustain. Okay, let me show you this here quickly. And the guitar is still ringing. Okay, I will stop here now. The guitar was still ringing. We got a lot of sustain on this guitar, yeah? This was something I didn't expect. I didn't expect all the brass here on this guitar. And something else that blew me a little bit away is we got here really a super shine fretboard. Can you see this here? And we got here an Indian rosewood fretboard, and this rosewood fretboard is lacquered, okay? They really made it shine and then lacquered it. So we got here really a mirror shine fretboard with mirror shine frets, and the whole fretboard is mirror shine. I really didn't expect this. I expected, you know, the guitar looks rough, and I expected a little rough fretboard too, but no. The guitar looks worn out and the fretboard looks super shiny, really super shiny. So that's the stuff I didn't expect. And the next thing is here in the electronic cavity. I will show you this right now. And we can see we got here a big pot, okay? Big volume pot. I know it's a big deal for some people. And the whole electronic cavity is shielded with graphite lacquer. The cable of the P90 is shielded too here. I don't know how you call it in English right now, but yeah, this is here, this, you know, metal stuff. The cover is shielded too. So that looks good. And we got here enough space, so if you really need a tone pot, you could build yourself a tone pot in here, okay? I hope you could see, we got here a big volume pot. I know it's a big deal for some people, little pots or big pots. And we got here a big pot. The whole cavity is shielded and it looks good, I know, I mean, what else can you say? You got enough space to make a tone pot if you really need one. So that's good too. Little details here are also, this guitar looks worn out, okay? And they made a good job with this. We got here a very thin layer of lacquer, okay? And we got no pore fillers here. So we can really feel and see all the pores on the guitar. And here on the edges, we can really feel the guitar, the wood, okay? So there's no big coat of clear coat on this guitar, no big layer of clear coat on this guitar. It's a very, very thin layer. So if we talk about sound, we got here just plus points on this guitar. Brass saddles, brass tuning pegs, and the graphite saddle. Very thin layer on the guitar. We got here, by the way, a Swamp Ash body. Four pieces, one, two, three, four pieces. Light guitar, in my opinion. I will show you the weight here right now, where Jimmy is. And a little detail, something you don't see on the online photos normally, is swamp ash body, and we got an ash veneer on the headstock, okay? This is not just black, this is a ash veneer, we can feel and see the grain. And there's a thin layer of black lacquer on the headstock. By the way, the headstock here, you know, this white slick, the K is Mr. Slick himself, as a K, and the logo is white lacquer. Also on the back, this is not nickel plated, okay? This plate here is not a nickel plated something, this is really steel, okay? Massive steel plate. And we got here Mr. Slick himself too, and the serial number. So if we talk about sustain, we got here just components that really make this guitar sing, okay? And the next thing is the P90 pickup. We got here a hand aged, we got here, you know, it's a little bit worn out, a little bit dirty. Slick Junior Ornico 5 P90 pickup with 9.6 kilo ohms. And we will hear this guitar right now in my Ignator 15 clean mode. And you will hear hopefully the sustain and how nice this pickup is. It's not a cheap pickup. I really expected here some generic pickup, but no, this is really made for this guitar by Slick, you know? Sustain, you know? There's really a lot of sustain going on this guitar. Okay, and let me show you the volume control. Works flawlessly, okay? In my opinion, works flawlessly. Really, you know, it goes straight down, gets quieter and quieter and quieter, and then it's off. Perfectly, in my opinion. No problems on this. So you can see, this guitar is really, you know, if I have to give this guitar a name, you know, a motto, it would be something like, you know, straightforward. It just got one direction, you know. One pickup, one volume control, so you got one sound, one good sound you have to form with your fingers, you know. If you want to make it sound a little bit more smooth, you know, you have to use your fingers, turn the volume a little bit down, play a little bit more around the neck here, not here. If you play here, you know, it sounds even crisper, and when you play here, you got more bass, okay? You can hear that? So, you have to form really the sound with your fingers here, okay? So if you want a little bit smoother, use your fingers and play more around the neck. Now let's use a little bit overdrive, the AC tone. Thank you. as you can see, I can reach the last thread easily. We got here this block, but I can reach, when my thumb hits this block, I'm with my last fingers already around the last thread. So it's not a problem to reach the last thread here, okay? Yeah, I really like it. So, what else can we say? Double cut body shape, yeah, of course. We got a brown wood grain, I already mentioned that. Very thin layer of lacquer here on this guitar, I really like it. We got swamp ash body, yes, I showed you the weight already. We got Canadian hard rock maple neck, yes. This is a one-piece neck with a glued-on headstock, so two pieces, you could say. 43 millimeter graphite nut. Yes, that's right, and the nut is well slotted. It's maybe a little bit rough on some edges here, but we got here no issues with the tuning stability thanks to this nut also. Indian rosewood fretboard, yes, and already I mentioned it, this is a really high polished fretboard and lacquered, you know, really, really super shiny fretboard. I really like it. 12 inch radius on the fretboard, yes. I'm not a big fan of specific radiuses on the fretboard, but it's comfortable. I can play easily on this fretboard with this radius. 22 frets, yes, and they are mirror shine. We got no rough fret ends. They are not perfectly rounded or something, but we got no rough fret ends. We got a scale length of 628 millimeters. Good, playable. Feels nice. Yeah, I can just say good things here. By the way, the neck is very comfortable. We got here a C neck, and as you could see here right now, it lays really comfortable in my hand. I can really do this tremolo stuff very easily with this neck. Really dig the feel of this. One hand-aged slick junior pickup. Yes, I already talked about it. Good sounding pickup, much better than I really expected. One volume knob, and by the way, the volume knob is brass too. This is brass. Brass, brass, brass. Yes? They used brass on these guitars like crazy. And I think it's good. Can't be a bad thing, it's good. 269 euro is the price of this guitar here in Europe. As far as I know. And yeah, that's all the specifications, okay? I think I talked about everything on this guitar. Some people mentioned the headstock. The headstock would be very uninspired. I think it looks good. It fits the guitar, you know. It's a simple design. The guitar is a simple design. And we got here a simple headstock. And I think it fits the guitar, okay? Just my opinion here, probably. I think it fits the guitar. And that's the most important thing. The design of the whole guitar fits together, in my opinion. So much talking, I would say let's play. Let's play the heck out of this guitar right now. Let me show you one thing. We got a P90 pickup, but the P90 pickup, as you know, the electronic cavity is shielded very well. It's not noisy. It's not a very noisy pickup. Little bit here, you know, but that's very, very good. I have to say, I got here really some ground problems on my house, and this is very good. This just little noise we got. So yeah, let's hear the AC tone a little bit more. Thank you. very much. Reminds me a lot of Keith Richards stuff, you know, and rock stuff in general. The pickup, the whole guitar gives you a good sound, a good solid sound, and you can form it with your fingers and your pedals and your amp. And that's what we will do now. I will go with the Ultimate Drive here right now. Will be a much thicker sound here right now. Ultimate Drive boosted with the Vintage Overdrive. I didn't talk about the harmonics. You can get out the harmonics of this guitar very easily, thanks to the brass, all the brass stuff. I'm not sure, but you can get it out easily. Can really make this guitar squeal, you know, scream and squeal. I really like it. And let's do drop tuning here right now. So, final words, let me take here a nap. I already said everything, okay? I was blown away, to be honest. I didn't expect it all this. I didn't expect it all the brass. I didn't expect it the very well done electronic cavity, the good sounding pickup, and the overall good craftsmanship. I didn't expect it this, to be honest. So, that was the very, very short final words here right now. So it's a very recommended guitar. If you like this body shape, if you like this design, I really dig this design, okay? For me, it's a big plus point, everything on this guitar here. The very thin lacquer, everything adds, in my opinion, to sound and sustain and look. You know, I got here everywhere super shiny guitars around me with thick layers of lacquer. So this guitar is really something special right now for me. And I dig the Just One pickup. Just One P90, you have to really form the sound with your fingers. So, and I think I repeat myself here right now. So let's stop this here. And what can I say? 269 euro is the price approximately here in Europe. And yeah, highly recommended in my opinion. I really, really dig this guitar much more than I expected. They are not so well known here in Europe right now. I hope it will change here, maybe even with this video here right now. If you need a second P90 pickup, there's also the Slick SL60, this here, okay? Available in black and yellow and in more colors, I don't know right now. This review will come soon too. I think that's it. If you got questions, please comment in my Facebook groups. All the links will be in the description below. Please check this out. And I really hope you liked this video. By the way, if you understand German, I got a second channel, the Blue Channel. This is the Red English Channel and I got a Blue German Channel. The review will be there too. So if you understand German, you can watch both. Okay? And yeah, that's it. Have a nice day. Bye bye.